Leading us in prayer today is Father Marco, and my name is Tim Reese. Our parish participates today in the Catholic Charities of Southeast Michigan campaign. Your support of this annual collection will help the church address the cycle of poverty that afflicts many in our own country. Today at Mass, we also welcome the families of our third and fourth grade students whose religious studies highlight the seven sacraments, the 12 apostles, the saints, and the Ten Commandments. We will ask God's blessing upon them as they grow in wisdom and faith. Today we listen to one of Jesus' most powerful parables. This is the story about serving the needs of others that sums up the mission we must carry out every day as followers of Christ our King. So let us join our voices now in praise of God with the hymn, "To Jesus Christ, our Sovereign King," found in your program. But first, please stand to greet the Lord in present in one another.
Jesus Christ, our Sovereign King,
who is thy word salvation, all praise and homage do we bring, and thanks and adoration. Christ Jesus, Victor, Christ Jesus,
in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Grace to you and peace from God our Father and the Lord Jesus Christ.
And with your spirit.
Jesus, Holy Scripture today refers to us as sheep. In three of our readings today, he refers to us as sheep. And sheep wander, they get lost, but our good, loving Lord brings us back always with his mercy and his grace. So let's open our hearts right now to receive his light, direction, mercy, and grace into our lives, into our hearts, as we acknowledge our sins and so prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries. Lord Jesus, you are mighty God and Prince of Peace. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, you are Son of God and Son of Mary. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, you are Word made flesh and splendor the Father. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Glory to God, glory to God, glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to people of goodwill. We praise you, we bless you, we adore you, we glorify you. We give you thanks for your great glory, Lord God, Heavenly King, O God, Almighty Father. Glory to God, glory to God, glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to people of Lord Jesus Christ, only begotten Son. Lord God, Lamb of God, Son of the Father, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. You take away the sins of the world, receive our prayer. You are seated at the right hand of the Father. Have mercy on us. Glory to God, glory to God, glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to people of For you alone are the Holy One, you alone are the Lord, you alone are the Most High, Jesus Christ. With the Holy Spirit in the glory of God the Father, glory to God, glory to God. Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to people of goodwill. Amen.
Let us pray. Almighty ever-living God, whose will is to restore all things, in your beloved Son, the King of the universe, grant, we pray, that the whole creation, set free from slavery, may render your majesty service and ceaselessly proclaim your praise through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
A reading from the book of the prophet Ezekiel. Thus says the Lord God, I myself will look after and tend my sheep. As a shepherd tends his flock when he finds himself among his scattered sheep, so I will tend my sheep. I will rescue them from every place where they were scattered when it was cloudy and dark. I myself will pasture my sheep. I myself will give them rest, says the Lord God. The lost I will seek out, the stray I will bring back, the injured I will bind up, the sick I will heal. But the sleek and the strong I will destroy, shepherding them rightly. As for you, my sheep, says the Lord God, I will judge between one sheep and another, between rams and goats. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
shepherd is the Lord, nothing indeed shall I want.
Lord, you are my shepherd, there is nothing I shall want. Fresh and green are the pastures where you give me repose. Near restful waters you lead me to revive my drooping spirit.
My shepherd is the Lord, nothing indeed shall I want.
I should walk in the valley of darkness, no evil would I fear. You are there with your crook and your staff. With these you give me comfort.
My shepherd is the Lord, nothing indeed shall I want.
You have prepared a banquet for me in the sight of my foes. My head you have anointed with oil. My cup is overflowing.
My shepherd is the Lord, nothing indeed shall I want.
A reading from the first letter of St. Paul to the Corinthians. Brothers and sisters, Christ has been raised from the dead, the first fruits of those who have fallen asleep. For since death came through man, the resurrection of the dead came also through man. For just as in Adam all die, so too in Christ shall all be brought to life, but each one in proper order. Christ the first fruits, then at his coming, those who belong to Christ. Then comes the end, when he hands over the kingdom to his God and Father, when he has destroyed every sovereignty and every authority and every power. For he must reign until he has put all his enemies under his feet. The last enemy to be destroyed is death. When everything is subjected to him, then the Son himself will also be subjected to the one who subjected everything to him, so that God may be all in all. The word of the Lord.
The kingdom of our father David, that is is to come.
The Lord be with you.
A
reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew. Jesus said to his disciples, "When the Son of Man comes in his glory, and all the angels with him, he will sit upon his glorious throne, and all the nations will be assembled before him. And he will separate them one from another, as a shepherd separates the sheep from the goats. He will place the sheep on his right and the goats on his left. Then the king will say to those on his right, 'Come, you who are blessed by my Father, inherit the kingdom prepared for you from the foundation of the world. For I was hungry, and you gave me food. I was thirsty, and you gave me drink. A stranger, and you welcomed me. Naked, and you clothed me. Ill, and you cared for me. In prison, and you visited me.' Then the righteous will answer him and say, 'Lord, when did we see you hungry and feed you, or thirsty and give you drink? When did we see you a stranger and welcome you, or naked and clothe you? Or when did we see you ill or in prison and visit you?' And the king will say to them in reply, 'Amen, I say to you, whatever you did for one of these least brothers of mine, you did for me.' Then he will say to those on his left, 'Depart from me, you accursed, into the eternal fire prepared for the devil and his angels. For I was hungry, and you gave me no food. I was thirsty, and you gave me no drink. A stranger, and you gave me no welcome. Naked, and you gave me no clothing. Ill and in prison, and you did not care for me.' Then they will answer and say, 'Lord, when did we see you hungry or thirsty, or a stranger or naked or ill or in prison, and not minister to your needs?' He will answer them, 'Amen, I say to you, what you did not do for one of these least ones, you did not do for me.' And these will go off to eternal punishment, but the righteous to eternal life." The Gospel of the Lord. So God uses, throughout Scripture, this shepherd-sheep analogy to explain his relationship with us. God refers to us as sheep 400 times in the Bible. 400 times in the Bible, we are referred to as sheep. As I've mentioned in prior homilies, my mother, in her prior life, was a shepherdess of over 1,000 sheep. And I have to always ask her for insight about shepherding. I will do this for the rest of my priesthood when I have these passages about the sheep and the shepherd. And as I was praying on these readings in preparation for my homily, I called her, my mom, and I asked her. I said, "Mom, sheep, they're pretty dumb animals, right, Mom? Right? They're pretty dumb." And she responded to me, no, they are wonderful. They trust." That's what she said to me. "No, they are wonderful. They trust. They trust. They rely on their shepherd. They know the voice of the shepherd." This is a good reason why God likes to speak to us as sheep. So it is absolutely necessary for a Christian to embrace the reality that we need a shepherd in all aspects of our life, all of it. But let's be real and honest today. Let's be real and honest. Many, 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 many in our world, Christians as well, today live as though they have no need for a shepherd. No need for a shepherd. Let's look at, you know, let's look at our gospel today first. Let me look at this gospel. Matthew chapter 25. All that Jesus calls his disciples to, you and me, to do in this gospel, is in this gospel, right? Feed the hungry, clothe the naked, welcome the stranger. All these aspects, all these acts of mercy. And no one may have, but he's calling in this Matthew 25 right here, we see. But no one may have manifested these acts of mercy here that we hear of in Matthew chapter 25 more powerfully for us in this past century than Blessed Teresa of Calcutta, Mother Teresa. You know, back in the 1970s, Mother Teresa, in her visit to United States, Mother Teresa was asked by an American reporter, which is the poorest country you have been to, Mother Teresa? Which is the poorest country you have been to? And Mother Teresa, always bold and audacious, she responded, yes, yes, I have been to many countries and seen much poverty and suffering. Everywhere people tell me of their hardships and struggles, and I try to help them the best I can, she says. But of all the countries that I have been to, the poorest is America. And the reporter, somewhat shocked, rightly so, he informed Mother Teresa, you know, that United States is one of the richest countries in the world. Well, she's talking about a poverty of loneliness, a spiritual poverty here. Yes, there are people in our very rich country today, right now, who are materially poor, and we need to be generous in our works of mercy as Christians. But there is another poverty that needs to be needs more of our attention in our country, more attention. People in our country need to come to the full realization that they need a shepherd, that they need the Lord in their life. Poverty, this poverty that Mother Teresa speaks of, should be very clear to us, and it is, for the most part, it's very clear to us. The breakdown of the family. Young people have lost faith in marriage. So many hurting people. So many wounds due to our culture of death. So many people need to hear the message of God's healing mercy. Need to be touched, need their hearts to be touched by the healing hands of Jesus. You know, so many problems. The pornography business makes billions more money here in the United States than the three major sports combined. Major League Baseball, NFL, and NBA. And those slick, savvy business owners of this business are very pro-choice because of the success of their business is dependent on it. So they feed their money into the pro-choice movement. Our unwelcoming stone-cold hearts towards immigrants. This country was founded by the hard work of immigrants. Poverty. So many souls are lost because they believe that they can earn their sense of self-worth by careers, degrees, by living up to the culture's crushingly unrealistic expectations regarding the body image. And we judge ourselves, evaluate ourselves by these foolish, superficial standards of the world, and we judge others as well by them. You see what Mother Teresa is talking about here, challenging us to? Yes, you better believe it. You and me, we are lost sheep. We are lost sheep without our shepherd, without God Almighty, who is the fullness of love and truth. Shelter the homeless. You know, the corporate works of mercy come from Matthew chapter 25. Shelter the homeless, visit the sick, visit the imprisoned, bury the dead, etc. But there's also the spiritual works of mercy which we get from Scripture.
Admonish the sinner, instruct the ignorant, counsel the doubtful, comfort the sorrowful, bear the wrongs patiently of others. This is what we need. We need. They need this from us. We need this for ourselves, and people need this from us as Christians. You know, this is the core message of the new evangelization that which has been at the very is at the heart of Pope Francis. You know, he doesn't let a week go by without exhorting us to evangelize. This is what the new evangelization is, ultimately the work of mercy, to bring the message of Jesus by our words and actions to all we experience in our daily life. We are poor. We need the richness of Jesus. You know, another reason why in the Bible we so often hear of the shepherd-sheep analogy, it is because of all the master-animal relationships, the one that's most intimate is between the shepherd and his sheep, the most intimate. My mother knew her sheep. She knew her sheep. She knew her sheep. And they knew her, my mom. She knew her sheep. She's actually here today. Wow, look at that. Surprising. My mom's parents, her siblings, they lived and they worked in the farm with her and the sheep. But they did not know their voice. My mom, my grandparents, my uncles and aunts, they didn't know their voice, the sheep. They didn't listen to them. They didn't trust them like they did my mom. No way near like they did my mom. Why? Because my mom was with them 24/7. She loved them, cared for them. She protected them, fed them. There is closeness. There is intimacy, a familiarity between the shepherd and his sheep. And you and I are called to have that with the Lord. We are called to have that with the Lord. That is why we pray, why we read Scripture, why we come to celebrate the praises of God at this Holy Mass. In order to enter into a deep familiarity with the Lord, in order to enter into a deep familiarity with the Lord, we have to first come to a realization of our need for a shepherd. The prophet Ezekiel, my mother, they show us that sheep are needy. They are needy because they can easily get lost. They can wander from the shepherd. Also, sheep, they're weak. They're vulnerable. Yes, they need protection, someone to bind them up when they are injured. We have to realize this about ourselves. Yes, the Lord is calling us away from self-sufficiency and moving us to the reality, to reality. A reality that's good news. It's familiarity with Jesus, familiarity with his humility, you know, familiarity with his tenderness. Familiarity with his reverence to the dignity of every man and woman. Familiarity with his chastity, with his compassion. Familiarity with the love and honor he has for you and me. Familiarity with his joy. You know, in Scripture, after he gets rejected, dejected by people, you know, after he gets rejected, dejected by people, what's Jesus' response? He rejoices in the Father. He rejoices in the Father. He never carries with himself in Scripture a defeatist attitude. No matter how difficult the situation, how disheartening the situation is, because he's in union with the Father. And when he calls us to be in communion with the Father, to share in the Father's joy, to share in the Father's love. So at the end of our lives, when we meet Jesus, we will know him. We want to know him. And we want him to call us one of his sheep when we meet him at the end of our lives. Because, why? Because we are intimate with him, familiar in our earthly life with the person of Jesus, his ways, his truth and love. We are familiar with how he is present in the suffering that we encounter, those physically as well as spiritually. Pope Francis, the joy, in his apostolic exhortation, the joy of the gospel, he speaks of a need to bring Jesus to others, not with a defeatist attitude, but with fervor, generosity, boundless love and attraction, he says, with joy. And such joy only comes when we have a deep familiarity, relationship with the Lord, our shepherd, our king. And it doesn't get deeper for us. It doesn't get more personal for me and you, being in the presence of Jesus, than when you and I receive the very body and blood of Jesus in the Eucharist. Let's receive him today with wide open hearts. Let us offer all our prayers to the Lord, our King and our Shepherd. Oh, first day. Let us profess our faith to our Lord and King. Brothers and sisters, I believe in God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only Son, my Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father, through whom all things were made, for our sin and for our salvation, he came down from heaven, by the power of the Holy Spirit, and was anointed with the Virgin Mary, and became man. For our sake, he was crucified in the Pontius Pilate, he suffered death and was buried. Let us offer our prayers to our Lord.
Let us pray for the church. God, we are your people, the flock, your guide. Bring us to the kingdom of your beloved Son. Bless our adults receiving the sacrament of confirmation this Sunday at Blessed Sacrament Chapel. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Let us pray that the world will be reconciled to Christ. Shepherd all people in the paths of justice and peace, O Lord. May the nations find the way of peace together. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Let us pray for the hungry, the homeless, and for all those in need. Strengthen our hands to serve others and our hearts to love them. Open our eyes, O Lord, to see you in every human face. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Let us pray for the sick and the suffering. May all who desire your comfort, O God, and find friends to serve them. We pray especially for Betsy Moore, Gary Marcioni, Muriel Pacchetti, Donna Ledger, and Gary Marcioni, and for all those who have asked for our prayers. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Let us remember the dead. May all come to life in Christ again and enjoy eternal glory, especially Stephen Palich, Richard Klinger, Dolores and Stuart Chambers. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
And let us pray for our personal needs now in a moment of silence. Loving and compassionate Lord, grace our tables this Thanksgiving holiday. Let your love rule our families. Be with those who will be alone. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer. Loving Father, we offer all our prayers to you in the name of Jesus Christ, our Lord and our King, who lives and reigns with you in the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Guide me.
Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. As we offer you, O Lord, the sacrifice by which the human race is reconciled to you, we humbly pray that your Son himself may bestow on all of us the gifts of unity and peace through Christ our Lord. Amen. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For you anointed your only begotten Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, with the oil of gladness as eternal priest and king of all creation, so that by offering himself on the altar of the cross as a spotless sacrifice to bring us peace, he might accomplish the mysteries of human redemption, and making all created things subject to his rule, he might present to the immensity of your majesty an eternal and universal kingdom, a kingdom of truth and life, a kingdom of holiness and grace, a kingdom of justice, love, and peace. And so with the angels and archangels, with the thrones and dominions, and with all the hosts and powers of heaven, we sing the hymn of your glory, as without end we acclaim. You are indeed holy, O Lord, and all you have created rightly gives you praise. For through your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, by the power and working of the Holy Spirit, you give life to all things and make them holy. And you never cease to gather a people to yourself, so that from the rising of the sun to its setting, a pure sacrifice may be offered to your name. Therefore, O Lord, we humbly implore you by the same Spirit, graciously make holy these gifts we have brought to you for consecration, that they may become the body and blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, at whose command we celebrate these mysteries. For on the night he was betrayed, he himself took bread, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice and giving you thanks, he said the blessing and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me. The mystery of faith.
When we eat this bread and drink this cup, we proclaim your death, O Lord, until you come again.
Therefore, O Lord, as we celebrate the memorial of the saving passion of your Son, his wondrous resurrection and ascension into heaven, and as we look forward to his second coming, we offer you in thanksgiving this holy and living sacrifice. Look, we pray, upon the oblation of your church and recognizing the sacrificial victim by whose death you will to reconcile us to yourself. Grant that we who are nourished by the body and blood of your Son and filled with his Holy Spirit may become one body, one spirit in Christ. May he make of us an eternal offering to you so that we may obtain an inheritance with your elect, especially with the most blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with blessed Joseph, her spouse, with your blessed apostles and glorious martyrs, and with all the saints on whose constant intercession in your presence we rely for unfailing help. May this sacrifice of our reconciliation, we pray, O Lord, advance the peace and salvation of all the world. Be pleased to confirm in faith and charity your pilgrim church on earth, with your servant, Francis, our Pope, and Alan, our Bishop, the Order of Bishops, all the clergy, and the entire people you have gained for your own. Listen graciously to the prayers of this family whom you have summoned before you. In your compassion, O merciful Father, gather to yourself all your children scattered throughout the world. To our departed brothers and sisters and to all who are pleasing to you at their passing from this life, give kind amends to your kingdom. There we hope to enjoy forever the fullness of your glory, through Christ our Lord, through whom you bestow on the world all that is good. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen.
At the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
The kingdom, power, and glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. Amen. The peace of the Lord be with you always. Let us offer each other the sign of peace. Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Let us pray. Having received the food of immortality, we ask, O Lord, that glorying in obedience to the commands of Christ, the King of the universe, we may live with him eternally in his heavenly kingdom, who lives and reigns forever and ever. Amen. Now for our announcements.
Many thanks to the 503 parish households who have responded to our annual treasure renewal with a total of $452,000 pledged. We hope everyone will make a prayerful response to this initiative. Today in Marion Hall or our gathering area, you will find the Right to Life Lifespan Christmas card sale, the Advent Giving Tree filled with tags to provide a gift for a needy person this Christmas, a sign-up station for the lighting of the Advent wreath at our Masses, and Advent Daily Prayer Books. Those who would like to adopt a family this Christmas season, please leave a message for Colleen Schultz of Christian Service at the parish office. All are invited to join us at 6 p.m. tomorrow, Sunday evening, for a community Thanksgiving service here at St. Joseph's. Clergy, ministers, and members of local Christian churches in Lake Orion and Oxford will gather here to praise and thank God for the many blessings. Please join us. And lastly, this Thursday is Thanksgiving Day, our national holiday. Mass will be celebrated at 9 a.m., and all are invited to come and offer thanks to God on this special day.
Now invite all our third and fourth graders for all those in the third and fourth grade, public, private, Catholic, homeschool, to come up. Thanks. We're going to give you a blessing. Very good. Okay. It's a joy to see all of you here today. Okay, now for a blessing. Good and gracious Lord, we ask for your blessings upon these, your children. Fill them this coming school, this school year, with a desire for knowledge, a self-discipline, and may they grow in greater trust and love for you, Lord. We ask this all in your name. Amen. Thank you, guys. God bless you. You know, when I have bad breath, the first person to tell me that I have bad breath is my mom, because she loves me. She's the first one to tell me I have bad breath because she loves me. You know, our Holy Father, Pope Francis, he says that corruption is like bad breath. You don't know you have it unless somebody tells you. So, you know, we don't want to be negative all the time. We don't want to be negative. But it's good once in a while to tell people about the bad breath that's going on in our culture. It's a good thing. It's a good and healthy, nice way to mention that. Okay, so with that said, let's ask for the Lord's blessing. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
And may Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go in the peace, love, and joy of Jesus Christ.
Thanks be to God. Crown him with many crowns, the Lamb upon his throne. All kingdoms of the earth resound in praise of him alone.